What up YouTube, it's me Ki back in another weekly video. And how do you like my new haircut, huh? The reason why I wear hat in almost every of my video is because my hair grew so much in Nitra and it looks so bad, as you can see in one of my video here.
So the place that I want to see.
Yeah, I regret my decision not to wear a hat during the video, so whatever. So, to our main topic today. So last week, I just went to a big wedding party, a big one, and it got me thinking. I realized there were a lot of things happened in Indonesian wedding, and I think it is probably a quite interesting thing to talk about. Why should you watch this video, you ask? Let's imagine a situation. You are a foreigner, and you just came to Indonesia. Then somebody, you know, invited you to a wedding party, which you probably already guessed it is far more different from your typical Western wedding. And you are correct, and you don't know what to do prior to the wedding, and now you realize this video is somewhat useful to you. So I present to you a guide to the great Indonesian wedding. The first thing you want to know is how different is Indonesian wedding compared to your typical Western wedding. One difference is the size, which I kid you not, Indonesian wedding is huge, big, and supposed to be public. And how big it is depends on how big your extended family is or how important your parents are. If you are invited to a big Indonesian wedding, chances are you only know only 5% of the attendant because, well, you see. And because of the massive scales, you can always attend some stranger's wedding and they won't even notice. I was once doing it and it was real fun. So if you are a foreigner invited to a wedding, the first thing you're going to do when you arrive at the location is to find a reception, which usually is at the main entrance. All you have to do is write your name and your signature so that the family knows that you are coming. Because again, as I said, the wedding is so big the family won't even remember who's coming or not. And then, here's the thing, the receptionist will give you some souvenir. Do not hesitate to take it because it is a very common thing to do. This souvenir can be as simple as a hand fan or something weird like a romantic candle with a photo of the groom and the bride. Yep. In any case, just take the souvenirs and embrace it whenever you get back home. So next to the reception, there is a box where you can put some money in an envelope. I don't know where does it come from, but it is a common thing to do to put some money inside. I don't think that it is necessary, but I always put some money as my way of saying thank you for the meal, which we will get to it later. And as you get into the hall, you may be overwhelmed by the number of the guests there, and there would be a lot of foods. But first thing first, immediately look for the line that leads you to this main stage where the married couple and the families are waiting for the guests to come and shake their hands or something like that. Just wait in line until it is your turn and shake their hand, but don't get offended if they don't recognize you because, well, sometimes it can be very tiring for them and you know. And after you're done, we can finally talk about the most exciting part in Indonesian wedding, which is the feast. So the food served in a buffet style, so you can pick whatever you like. But first, there's something you need to know. Generally, there are three types of food served in a wedding. The first, which is a typical Indonesian meal, which consists of rice and stuff like chicken or fish or vegetable or something like that. Next, a dessert table which serve pudding or tiny cakes or fruits. And lastly, the main attraction in the wedding, which is a different variety of exotic food which comes in the different tiny stalls. And these tiny stalls are scattered all over the hall, in which you can visit each one of them to have some portion for yourself. So they serve a lot of interesting food such as sushi, lasagna, Korean barbecue, dim sum, sade, bakso, or anything like that. So this food serve in a tiny bit portion because people tend to prioritize this kind of food over your more traditional meal. So make sure you visit these stalls before you even go to another type of meal. So please keep in mind that this typical wedding only lasts for 2 or 3 hours because they only have short-term duration in renting the building. So make sure to be there early when there's only a few people, and so that you can try these stalls before anyone else can. Indonesian wedding is sure an interesting experience, and if you are invited to see one, I urge you to go and experience it yourself. Or if you are not invited, you can always go to a stranger's wedding like me. And that's it for now. Thank you for watching and sticking with me until the end of the video. I hope you enjoy it. And as always, if you want to see more videos like this, please leave your thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Make sure to check all my links and follow me in all my social media. And I'll see you again in the next video. Ciao!